Hello, welcome everyone. My name is Fleur. This is my studio from home, and we're going to do a fun vinyasa flow class together for about 30 minutes. So let's start by just coming to our space. Come to the front of your mat. I'll just face you for this first bit. You can have your feet hip widths apart, or you can bring your big toes together, touching with your heels slightly apart. Stand nice and tall. Maybe roll your shoulders up to your ears, roll them back and then down. And then think of fingertips reaching gently to the floor. Open your palms forwards. Draw your chin a little bit in so that you are lengthening through the back of the neck. And then check where your pelvis is. Have you got a tilt where you're poking it out of the back, or do you have a tilt where you're squeezing your glutes and pushing the hips forward? And just see if you can find a position where it feels like you're lifting up from the waistline upwards, activating a little bit through the core, drawing it inwards and up. Once you feel you're in a position where you're not cramping or gripping anywhere, you're just standing tall, start to close your eyes up to the front. Take a deep breath in through the nose and exhale, sigh out through the mouth. And then just stand for a few moments and breathe. Start to accumulate the breath that you can hear at the back of the throat, like a sigh, gentle sigh with the mouth closed, sounding a bit like a wave, like the ocean. Think of breathing into the sides of your ribs. Notice the balance that your body is doing to stand upright. Feel yourself in this space and imagine your space is growing wider. Maybe lift your toes and spread them on the mat so you have a bigger spread through the feet. And then from here, bring the hands to your heart center and set your intention for your practice. Send out energy or love. Or maybe use this practice to come towards a higher version of yourself, which is already in you. But we want to try to break free of any eliminating thoughts or challenging thoughts that pull us down. Deep breath in. Breathe in and lift the arms up to the sky as you blink your eyes open, look up. Exhale, hinging forward, draw the belly in and fold to the floor. And then come halfway up. Bring the hands onto your shins or on your thighs, roll the shoulders back. Pull your belly and exhale, fold again, maybe hold behind your calves and draw the head down. Four more, inhaling, open the chest, feel the hamstrings. Exhale, belly pulls in and fold and pull yourself to your legs. For three, nice and long, just getting your spine warm, getting the hamstrings warm. Exhaling, fold. And four, lengthen. And again, release. Each time you become a little softer. Five, lengthen forward. Roll the shoulders back. And then fold down. Hold behind your ankles, your calves, or wherever you can hold. And just hold in here, five breaths. Little gentle release as you inhale and exhale. Pull yourself down with the legs. Inhaling again. Pull your navel in and up. And exhale, pull yourself down. Three. Exhale, find a bit more space without struggling. Four. And exhale, draw the elbows back if you can behind your calves. And five. Exhale, five. Release, soften the head, shake it out. Bring your hands onto the floor. Step yourself back into upward dog already. Feet hip widths apart, turn your toes slightly in, and then stretch your hips back and up. Stretch your arms really long. Turn your fingers slightly out to the side. As you inhale, come forward into a plank position. Chest forward, draw your belly in, squeeze your glutes. Exhale, push the hips back into downward facing dog. Four more. Inhale, come forward into a plank. Open the chest. Exhaling, pull the belly in and push the hips back. And again, inhaling forward into a plank. And exhale, push back, belly draws in. And one more, inhale, forward into plank. Exhale, push back, downward facing dog. And then from here, just walk out a little bit through your heels, see if you're feeling a little bit more open. Good.
And then from here, bring your toes together, touching. Lift your right leg up into the sky, balance on your left foot and draw the left heel down. Exhale, bend your right knee, bring the right foot between your hands. High lunge, inhale, reaching your arms up. Press down to the right foot, lift and stretch through the fingertips. Exhale, draw the belly in and reach your arms back. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, draw the arms back, chest comes forward. Press down on the right heel, three more. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, squeeze shoulders together. Two more. Long in the arms, reach the left heel away from you. Exhale, pull belly in. And one more. We're gonna hold it here in your lunge. Lengthen through the fingertips, left heel draws back. Breathe. As you exhale, pull the belly, but think the arms are stretching higher. Two more deep breaths. And five. Transfer the weight into the right leg, reach your arms back, lift your left leg up, two, left leg up, yeah, that's right, to the sky. Flex your toes down and stay here five breaths, rolling shoulders back. One, I know your right leg is starting to burn, get it nice and strong. Two, think of your intention and draw the heart forward. Look at somewhere for your eyes. You're only doing two more breaths, you've got that strength. Four, reach through your left heel, and five, bending your right knee, well done. Reaching the arms up, and then open the arms to a warrior two. So right heel aligned with your left after the foot. Inhale, straighten your right leg, and then exhale, bend your right knee, bring the right elbow down to the right thigh. Bring the left hand behind your back, and see if you can clasp either your grip of your pants or reach the hand just behind you so you bring the fingertips over your, what's it, right thigh. There you go. Roll the left shoulder back and down. Draw your chin slightly in and then rotate your chest up to the ceiling. Now if you're feeling strong in the right leg, see if you want to let go of the right arm and reach the right arm next to your ear. Control your breath. Breathe. One. Two. You've got the strength. Trust in yourself. Three. Four. Nearly there. One more breath. And five. Release the pose. Bring the left hand back down. Left hand to the floor. Bring both your hands inside of your right foot. Move the right foot to the side. And just move forwards and back. Straightening the right leg. Inhaling forward. Open the chest. Exhale. Push and slam. Three more, just to loosen it up a bit. Exhale, push back. And again, inhaling forward. My right leg just draws, so the right hip draws back. So stretch the left, right leg. And back, last one. Inhaling, open forward. And then bring the left knee down towards the floor. Untuck the back toes. Push into your right foot. Lift up the left arm. And then lean towards the right. So you're doing a little side stretch here. Lengthening the whole left side. Stay five breaths. One. Exhaling, lengthen. Breathe in two. And exhaling, draw the hips a bit forward. Three. And four. Last one. Five. Open the arm to the side. And then from here, step yourself forward to the front of the mat. Open the chest, feel your right leg, feel your left leg, exhale to fold. Inhale, reach your arms up, look to the thumbs, and then let's fold down again into your Uttanasana. Coming back, open the chest halfway up, hands down again, step yourself back to a downward dog. Draw the hips back, find the downward dog, push the hands into the floor, beautiful. And then from here, bring the toes together, touching with your left leg into the sky. Nice and high. Exhale, step your left foot forward between your hands. Inhale, reach your arms up into your high lunge. Hold it here. And then exhale, press into the left heel as you draw the chest forward and the arms back. Inhale, arms reach up, stretch up, Keep the back leg really straight. Exhaling, hinging, arms go back. For three, inhale, arms up. And exhale, belly pulls in, squeeze the shoulder blades together. For four, long breath. Exhaling, four, long in your neck. And for five, exhaling back. Draw your belly in, reach your arms up, hold it here, five breath. One, ground through your feet like roots. Two, each inhale, think of the arms reaching a little higher. Three, four, feel the strength of your legs, and five. Bringing your arms back down and back. Transfer the weight into your left foot and then lift your right leg off the floor. Flex your toes down to the floor, roll your shoulders back. Long in your chest, keep lifting the chest a little higher than your hips. One. Two. You are strong, you can hold this. Three. Reach through your right heel as if you want to reach to the back of the room. Four. And five, you've done it. Well done, bend your left knee. Step yourself back, and then windmill your arms open to a warrior two. I'll show you my back, it's fine. Find your warrior two position. Left heel on the line of your right arch. Breathe in, straighten your left leg, reach your arms up. Exhale, bend the left knee. Bring your left elbow to the left side. Right hand behind your back. And see if you can grab either the back of your pants, rolling the shoulders back, or reaching the right hand just over the left thigh. Draw left shoulder down. Draw the chin slightly and rotate your chest up while your knee is still turning to the left. Breathe, and if you want, lift up the left arm next to your left ear. Breathe in two. Think of your left heel as strong on the ground. Four. And five. Well done, you did it. Bring the left elbow down. Bring both hands down to the floor. Move your left foot a little bit out to the left side. And start to move forwards and back so you can straighten the left leg. Inhaling forward, drawing the hips down. Exhaling back. Your movement, your variation. Just a little flow, a little play. Inhale, open. Exhaling back. And one more. Inhaling, open. And exhale. Good, and from here, lean forward and then frame the foot. Step to the front of the mat. Open the chest halfway. Exhale, fold down, Uttanasana. Inhale, reach your arms up, look to the thumbs. And then hands to your heart, Samasthiti. Good, from here into a little balance. So I'm gonna take my hands to my hips. Feel again the roots through your feet. And then lift up through your right leg. Bring the right knee high up. Hold with your right hand, your right knee. And then from here, turn the knee out to the side. Grab with the right hand your right ankle. So you can place the foot right into the right thigh. I've forgotten something on the other side. So we have to go back down. I am so sorry. So we're gonna go back down. Sorry, bring the left knee down. This one I forgot. So left heel down, that happens. I can't do the idea. Come back into the position. What's it? This one. Where your right leg is, that left leg is for it. Apologies. And then we're going to reach the right arm up to the ceiling. Best laid plans. And then roll over to the left side. Oh dear. Breathing in. Five deep breaths. Stretch out through the right leg. Well, at least you know what's coming next. And again, deep breath in. Exhaling, slide to the side. Two deep breaths more. I'm so sorry. Four. And five. Coming back up. Now we're gonna step to the front. Step to the front of the mat. And then fold back down again. I hope you feel even now. Inhale, reach the arms up. Nothing worse than a video if you forgot what's coming next. Now we're gonna balance on our left leg. Bring up your right leg. Apologies. Turn to the side. Grab hold of your right ankle and bring the right foot into the left thigh, into your tree pose. If this is too challenging, bring the foot a little bit down. We can even just rest the heel onto the ankle. And then from here, bring the arms out to the side. Squeeze your foot into the thigh so you feel your left thigh activate. And then just lift your chest a little bit. Feel the arms like branches of the tree. Feel your fingers like leaves. And see if you can close your eyes. Just for a second, if that's too challenging or too scary, just keep them open. You can even close them a little bit. And then if you have the eyes open, bring your right hand onto the right knee. And then lean up through the left arm. And see if you can lean over to the right, like a willow. Ooh, it is challenging. So take your time, look at something that's not moving. And then breathe in, so come back. Stretch out your right leg to the side and cross your right ankle over your left knee. Bring your hands onto your hips. Slowly bend the left knee and sit back into a figure of four squat. Should feel quite nice, I hope, now. Draw the shoulders back, and if you like, you can reach the arms forwards. If you're feeling warm, if you're feeling strong, if you want to go a little further, see if you can bring the hands down towards the floor onto fingertips. And then maybe straighten your left leg and then bend it again. And see if you can come onto tiptoes of your left foot, keeping the right ankle over the left knee. A little prep here. Breathe. And then slowly come back, pushing into the fingertips, bring the left heel down. And then bend your knee, lift up through the arms, lift up the right knee, and step it back down. Shake out the legs, other side. Start by just bringing your left knee up, hands to your hips. And then turn the knee out to the side, bring your left hand onto the left ankle. Place your left heel into the right thigh. And then squeeze your glutes. Arms reach up. Arms open. Squeeze your glutes. Find your branches of your tree. And breathe. Keep the heart really open. Ground through your right foot. And then finding that side stretch. Side balance, the twisted tree, the willow, leaning over to one side. Stay slowly breathing. Play with this balance. Don't worry if you have to move the arms a bit, like I'm doing right now. Maybe there's a little moment of balance. Maybe it all feels really wobbly. It's all okay. And then from here, stretch out, come back. Stretch out the left leg to the side. And then flex your left foot over the right knee. I thought today I was really good at balancing, and as it proves, today is my wobble day. Here we are. And then slowly bring the hand either to your hips or reach the arms forward. Flex the left foot. Draw the hips back. Finding that nice openness in the hip. And if you like, if you have the arms forward, so you can bring them slowly down, pulling your belly button in so that you can draw the hips back. And then straighten the leg just for a moment, keeping the left foot where it is. And then bending down, maybe lifting your left heel. Just see if you can find a little squat here. Or any variations. And then coming back, pressing into the heels, pushing the floor down, lifting your arms up, using your back. Arms nice and long, push the floor away, lift up your left leg, and then place the foot down, shake out the legs. Beautiful, and then come back to the front of the mat. Breathe in, lift your arms up. As you exhale, fold forward, Uttanasana. Coming up halfway, expand the heart. And then step yourself back, high plank. Now we're gonna do five chaturangas.
So chaturanga, think of your plank position really strongly, drawing the belly button in, glutes active. And then a full chaturanga would be your elbows bend backwards, chest comes forward, chin comes slightly forward. Now this can be quite strong on the arms. So if that's too much, bring your knees down, keeping the toes tucked. And then again, think of bending your elbows back and then pushing the floor away. If you do it like any other variation where you just bring the nose in between your hands, you might put pressure onto your wrist or it might feel a little bit strainy in your neck. So let's try this together. With the knees down, or if you're very strong, from the plank position, pull in the navel. And then, as you breathe in, bring the chest forward. As you exhale, push the floor away. And again, inhale, forward. Exhale, push the floor away. Three more. Inhale, chest forward. Exhale, push the floor away. Keep your belly strong that you're not collapsing in your lower back. Last one. Inhaling, strong forward. Exhale, push the floor away. And then bring the knees down, and it's already down. Open your knees to the side and draw the hips back, and then stretch your arms out in front of you. And take a few long deep breaths. Breathing in and out, connecting again to the sound of Ujjayi. And then slowly coming back up. Knees underneath your hips and hands underneath the shoulders. And then from here, just cross your legs, sit back, and then bring your legs out in front of you. And let's just come to five beautiful Navasanas and Ardha Navasanas. Before we finish, lift up the legs, roll the shoulders back, activate the core, let go of your hands if you can. Take a breath in here. On your exhale, slowly roll the lower back down, nice and slowly, and then stretch your legs away from you like a dish. Inhale, lift up, Navasana. Exhale, slowly roll down, pull the belly in, Ardha Navasana, but hiccups sound great. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhaling, stretch away, Ardha Navasana. Two more, you can do it. Inhale, lift up, open your heart upwards. Exhale, roll back and stretch. Last one, inhale, lift the chest. And exhale, reach the feet forward and then hold it here. Pull in the navel, five breaths, one. Exhale, squeeze the legs together. Two, reach your fingertips to the front of your mat. Three, pull in the belly button. Four, lift your shoulder blades further higher up the floor. And one more, five. Exhale, bend your knees into your chest. Well done, and then roll the knees out to the side and in. Out to the side and in. And again, out to the side and in. Then change direction, go the other way, rounding. And again, rolling out and in. Good work, and then from here, hands behind your knees. Lift the feet and roll yourself up and down the spine for a little massage. And then roll yourself all the way over. Cross your legs again. Step yourself back into high plank. And then chaturanga, bend your elbows, slowly come down onto your belly. From here, roll the shoulders back. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders. Point your toes. And then breathe and lift your chest. Come to the lower part of your ribs and draw shoulders back. If you like, you can lift your hands. Hold it five breaths. One. If you like, you can lift your legs. Two. Three. Feel the stretch in the back. Four. The strength, I mean. And five. Release back down. Wriggle the hips. Bring your hands behind your back. Interlace the fingers. Keep the feet on the floor and then lift your chest up. Hold five breaths. One. Squeeze the glutes together. Two. Three. Four. And five. And slowly release down. Wriggle out through the hips. And then bend your knees. Bring the big toes together, touching. Reach for your outside of the feet. And then roll the shoulders back. And then kick into your feet. So the thighs come off the mat. And a bit out of breath.
Here we go. Find the breath again. Five breaths. One. You can also flex the feet as even lifts you a little higher. Two. Squeeze the knees a little together. Four. Five. Slowly release.
Well done. And then rest your forehead on the hands or look to the side. Wriggle out your hips. Bend your knees. Give yourself a little release for the back. Well done, everyone. And then from here, stretch your legs away. Hands under the shoulders. Tap the toes. Push the chest up. And then move the hips back. And then open the knees. One more time. Cross the legs and roll yourself over. Bring the soles of the feet together. Hold your feet. Lift the heart. And then fold forward, releasing the lower back. Relax the shoulders. Long breath in. And breathe out. Stay here. Letting everything soften now. And then slowly breathing in, roll yourself back up.
With the help of your hands, bring the knees back together. Stretch your legs out in front of you. Take another deep breath in, reach your arms up. Point your toes and then fold forward. And then you can either keep the toes pointed or maybe you'd like to flex the feet, depending where it feels good in your body. Stay five deep breaths. Two. Three. Take it nice and soft. Four. And five. Inhale, slowly release. Roll yourself back up. And then just a counter pose. Point your toes. And then lift your hips up. If this is too much, just set the feet in. Lift the hips. Just follow one little deep breath in here. And slowly come back down. And then stretch your legs out away from you. Arms forward. And roll yourself all the way down onto your mat. Open the arms to the side. Give yourself a little shake, a little wriggle. Take a deep breath in. Squeeze the body on the floor. And exhale. Sigh it out. And then relax the body down into the ground, into the earth. Let your fingertips naturally curl inwards. Become now aware of your breath, moving gently in and out. Or feel any sensations that feel good in your body. Become again friendly with all emotions, all sensations. Just a few more moments here. Feeling any tiredness, weariness, or worries moving away from you. Then let's take the last 3D breath here where we really connect to the breath and let go. So a full deep breath in through the nose. And a big sigh out. And again, two more. Breathing in. And release the air through the mouth, through the nose, whatever feels right for you. One more, don't be shy with yourself. Thank you. And again.
And then wiggle your fingers and your toes. You can reach your arms over your head, perhaps stretching long through the fingers and the toes. And then bring your knees into your chest. And if you're feeling a little slightly tired or soft, you can just hold them there for a moment, rocking maybe side to side. If you're feeling energy or energetic, maybe you want to rock up and down the spine. In any case, let's find the right way for you to come back up to seated, pushing the floor away when you're ready. Keeping the eyes closed or half closed so that you just come to sitting in a way that feels right. And then just rest your hands on your knees or your sides. Think of drawing the heart slightly back so you feel the spine become long. Try and relax the muscles in your legs, especially in your hips. And from here, bring the hands to your heart center. Remind yourself of your intention. And let's close. Take a deep breath in. And let the practice go with a big sigh. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope to see you again soon. Namaste.